Hello, everybody. Welcome to GameIndustry.com's walkthrough of Rooms, the Unsolvable Puzzle. This is a game which will be out officially on May 1st. So it's made by Handmade Game, and they wanted us to take a look at the first few levels of gameplay to show you guys what you can expect. This is a beautiful little game with a really cool story. This mansion was designed by this toy maker, and it disappeared mysteriously, and now this little girl has found it, and she can go through the mansion and solve a lot of puzzles. I think there's over 144 puzzles in the game, including over here these new basement puzzles, which are super hard. But let's go into the regular mansion first, because those of you that follow GameIndustry.com know that I am not the best puzzle solver. Usually this is done by Greg Crow. He's our puzzle game reviewer. But I'm going to do my best. So here we have the mansion. As you can see, these are the doors that I've already unlocked while I was playing around a little bit. And the mansion goes up much, much higher. And you can't go into rooms until you've solved the previous room. Also, these little pieces above the doorway, that says how well I've done in each room. So in this room, I didn't do that well, and this one I did okay. So let's go to room 3, just so I can show you a little bit of how it works. So here we have a fairly standard puzzle. This is a small one, and the one thing that's interesting is you'll notice this is the door. You always try to get to the door. But you can't get there because it's got walls around 3 sides. Now, the thing about this is that all of the puzzles are like this, and she is basically in a giant slide box. So she can slide the rooms, but only the rooms that she's in, so she can't slide any other room. So now here she is, and she's out the door. Well, that wasn't that hard. So let's go to door number 4. And here she's telling you, if you notice, some of these rooms are black and white, and some of them are in color. The ones that are in color are actually in the correct spot. And the other thing you can do is you can hold the lantern down, and he will give you some hints. So basically, well, this is the one hint that he gives you. He shows you where all the rooms are supposed to be located. So these are where the rooms are supposed to go, and then you can look at the colored ones versus the black and white ones and tell where you're actually at. So for this one, she needs to go here, but there's a lock. So, ow, I hit the wall, and she can't get through because there's a lock there. So we're going to go up and get the key. But now, you notice she can't immediately go back because there's a wall. But she could go down and get to the door. Now, these first few puzzles, of course, are extremely simplistic, but it shows you how the game works. Okay, let's go a little bit higher. Let's go to room 9. Just getting into slightly harder rooms. Alright, now this one's called Through the Roof, and this is a vertical puzzle. It's still it's basically a 6-square puzzle, but it is vertical. So you need to, I guess this is kind of teaching you to think both directions. Also notice there's a little car that runs across the bottom here. See it go right there? And that kind of gives you a hint as to where the rooms are supposed to be. So these rooms are adjacent to each other, and the car goes right across. And also, they're also in color, so not only are they in the right place, but the car's in the right place, so the rooms are actually in the right place because they're in color. Sometimes the car will go across and one of the rooms will be black and white, but that would mean that that room is in line, in the proper line, but not in the proper space. So, okay, let's give her a try. She goes up. Oh, this also introduces the telephone mechanic. So as you can see, there's a telephone here, and you can use that telephone to teleport to another telephone of the same color. Now she can go up and over, but then she can't go down because of the floor. Another thing is, over here on the left, you can see this is how many moves it should take you to solve the puzzle. Oftentimes it takes me a lot longer. So I'm already out of moves, but you can still solve the puzzle even if you're out of moves. She just tends to get upset, and she's like, you know, basically, you don't know what you're doing. Well, I know that, so stop yelling at me. Now, see, I have to get to this room, and I don't know how to do it. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, I can go up here. Go up, 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 up. Nope, won't work. Then she's stuck. Not completely, though. I can go down here. You can see I'm way past my move count. But that's okay. Because I'm about to get out of here. Alright, so there we go. Down and out. And now the lantern will probably yell at you and say, "You didn't do very good. You're not as smart as I thought you were, little girl." Well, I'm not. But let's, dare us, let's try going into the basement. So here we are going down into the basement. And these are the super hard basement rooms. And she gets a new outfit, so she's dressed as a schoolgirl. But the one thing she has is a cell phone, so she can use a cell phone to call one of the regular phones. Let me show you. I'm going to go to room 2 here. So the weird thing about cell phones is you can only use them once, so right now I don't have any uses of the cell phone. And this puzzle, even though it looks like a small little puzzle, it actually should only... It should take 8 moves to solve, so that's quite a lot of moving. Let's give it a try. First thing, run over and get the cell phone. Now, I have one use of the cell phone, so if I were to use it right now, I don't know if that would necessarily be a good thing. Because I have to basically get a down ladder. Or no, I just have to have a room. This room would work as the top. That's not gonna work. Okay. So that room's in the right place. Oh, maybe. And then down. Still need to get to that cell phone somehow. Okay, maybe use my cell phone to get over there. And then this basically has to just get out of the way. There we go. And up. And over, and out of here. So there's an example of a basement puzzle, and I actually solved it with one move left. So I guess that was pretty good. Thank you, Mr. Lantern. That was actually pretty terrible, but it's about as good as I can do with games like this. All right, let's go to room 4, which is, let me show you something cool. So this is the first room to introduce in the basement levels a new mechanic. If you see these walls are just barely, they're not solid wood like these other ones. They're just real weak. And so what you do is you can open this jack-in-the-box. And he will disintegrate the walls. Unfortunately, he'll also disintegrate you. So, if you die, you can just start over. Also, if you run out of cell phone usage, and you're basically painted yourself a new corner, you can just hit escape and retry. And you can retry the level again, no big deal. So let's see. So we got her, and then let's get out of here. And we think, oh, we've done it, right? Oh, but unfortunately, she's still stuck. She still can't get through that wall. So, and I can't activate it from the other side. So this would be an instance where you're pretty much stuck. There's nothing more that you can do. You have to retry. So this is one where you have to be quick. So not only do I have to use the cell phone and get up there, but I gotta get this room down there in time so that it blows up that other wall. And even though I was really close to the explosion, because I was on the other side of the wall, I was still alive. So here, just for fun. Good, you're awesome. Really, I'm not that awesome. But these are the basement rooms. So the basement rooms are, they introduce the cell phone mechanic, a new outfit, and they're a lot harder than the upstairs rooms. Let's go back upstairs. You see, these parts of the mansion are all locked because we haven't gone through them yet. Also, every now and then you'll see a picture of a little dude who's like in a nightcap, and that means that that's a story mission. When you click on it, it will trigger a cutscene that explains a little bit about what's going on in the game. Really beautiful graphics. Okay, blew up and down. So, in this one, you've got blue phones that go to blue phones and red phones that go to red phones. The door is up here, so it's completely walled off at the moment, but the only way you're going to be able to get into it is to take a... is to go from a room and walk into the left. Now, here's that little car that I was showing you guys before. See how it goes across there? It's not shown here, so this room does not belong here. Obviously, it's also the wrong color. But I don't see it anywhere else either, but at least we know that this room shouldn't be here. Now, we can't go up, so the only thing we can do is walk into this room. Notice that didn't take a click off the counter. To remove the counter click, you actually have to move the room. So I could make this room go up, or I could call and go up here. I'm thinking here, and then here. Okay, and then that goes green. The reason... they are pieces of a cursed puppet. When the rooms are all connected, these pieces will be too. Okay, so that probably... like, here's the other piece. There's a little head down here, and I guess this is like the body. So that's kind of a hint, I'm guessing. So now those pieces are together. Although I'm not really sure what that did for me. I can go to the red phone. I know I have to clear this out, because I have to get that piece out of there. Basically, I'm pretty sure I have to move this one up. But I don't know how to get to it. Let's see. It's not gonna help. Can't get to the blue phone. Oh, maybe I was wrong. Maybe I can't move that one down. Well, let's try moving it over. Can't go down. Can't go left. Can't go right. I could call out of here. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, the door opened. Hey, two puzzle pieces is not bad. Alright, so that was... this is room 11. Wish me luck. 6x6. The magic closet switches the room's locations. Okay. And I can do this in three moves. Oh. Well, if I could get... Huh, if I could get down there... Oh, dummy. I had solved it and I didn't even realize. I've earned 30 puzzle pieces. You're the smartest kid I've ever seen in the mansion. Actually, Greg Carl will be the smartest kid that this guy will ever see in the mansion. But I'm a good substitute here. Let's do one more, or attempt to. Okay, now here's that car again, which I believe is some type of a hint. It rolls across there. This room's out of position, though. Now it's in position. The car rolls through perfectly. But I have to get to that key, and the only way to get to that key is to use a ladder piece. So I think it's over. Switch with the wardrobe. Oh, but then I'm stuck there. It did not help me. And that's not gonna help. That one was in the right place. Oh, duh, I can just go down. This is why I'm so bad at these games. There we go, got a key. Now, I can't just switch them, right? Because that would put me... I could try, but I mean, that puts the... makes the door close. I'm gonna switch it again? Oh yeah, the room switch is just fine, but I'm not in the room. There we go. I got the key. Oh, there's a wall in the way. So, oddly enough, everything's in the right position. No, this one's not. Oh, over. Switch the rooms again to get rid of the wall. There we go. And I'm out. Total number of room moves has reached 400. That's probably not a good thing. Probably a good person could have done it in like 100. So, I got a trophy for taking four times as long. Yeah, thanks, Lantern. I know I could have done better. This is... amazingly addictive, and I am not a very good puzzle gamer, but here I am thinking these are pretty cool. So here's another one. Oh, there's another one of those vertical ones. Yeah, I figured that out. Thanks, Lantern. Okay, so we got a switch room. Can't go up because there's a wall. I could go down, switch the room. Well, what if I switch the rooms? Not helpful. I think that's like back where we started. Let's look at the lantern. Two at the top, three at the bottom. Only one thing's in the right position. Which is the one I'm thinking about moving. Okay, I think I got it. If I switch these rooms, then I can go actually go up here. I can move that out of the way and come back down. Oh, won't this room just lead me out? Remember, less moves, more puzzles. Alright, I'll attempt one more, guys, and then I'm gonna call it. You know how embarrassing it is to do this Uplay video and then not be able to actually solve the puzzles. Okay, so we've got the car, and the car goes here, and then here, and then there. So does that mean that that is in the right place there? Probably. I gotta get to that door somehow. Oh, so the switch room has a phone. I'm trapped there, so I don't have any way out of it. Maybe I should restart, yeah, maybe. But we ain't. We're sticking with it. That locks me in. Okay, so... Wow, it's like everything's in the right position. Yeah, except I can't... Oh, wait. Oh, no, I still can't get to the door. I got a clear shot, but you gotta remember, it's not teleporting you. Wait a minute, though. If I was down... Oh, I can do it. Wait. Change the room. And I should have a shot to the door. I only took 300 moves! You could have done better, though, you think? So, anyway, so this is from Handmade Game, and if you are a puzzle lover, this is really cool. Let's see if I actually earned a couple trophies in my little playthrough. They didn't want me to go beyond certain rooms in the preview, so I'm not going to do that, although I don't know if I could have. But this was a lot of fun. So if you are looking forward to a really cool puzzle game that has a different mechanic than you've seen before, you know, we've seen a lot in the puzzle genre that's been like match 3 and stuff like that lately. This is totally different than that. So this is pretty cool. And it's out May 1st officially, and it's from Handmade Game. This version is on Steam, or will be on Steam, the full version. And I hope you guys enjoyed watching me muddle through the game, and if you play, I'm sure you'll do a whole lot better than me. So, this is me signing off. I'll just do my signature. Alright, everyone. Hope you enjoyed this, and we'll be doing a full review, although it'll be our puzzle reviewer, when the full game comes out. It's just a couple more weeks left to wait. Take care, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. And please subscribe to our channel. We'll be giving you a lot of cool stuff like this in way of previews and things like that. I'm John Breeden with GameIndustry.com.